Hello everyone. Welcome. Welcome to Sun Dragon Cards. My name is Jennifer and thank you so much for joining me today. This video is just a craft with me. I am in the process of making this envelope journal, which by the way is inspired by Donna from Twisted Paper. Yes, Twisted Paper Studio. And I'll make sure to link her video that inspired me to do this. Now, this envelope journal is nowhere near as pretty as what she has done. And it's also a different design, but I've always wanted to do an envelope journal. And here we go. The digitals here are used, are from Heather at Ruby and Pearl. Her kits in here are the Seaside Dreams and By the Sea, and I thought that would be a really good theme, appropriate for this time of year where everybody is out vacationing and going to the seaside. I need to finish decorating and putting these things in here, but her Heather's kit is just gorgeous. If you can see, this is one of the images in the front here, and there's lots of little images and pictures that I want to add and make Ephirma with. And but yes, look at that. Isn't that great? Heather really just does a beautiful job with her digitals. I just love, love, love her digitals. And you can make it as shabby or vintage looking or grungy or romantic, however you want to, whatever style that you're into is, her images are just, and her digitals are just perfect. So here we go. Thought I would go ahead. I love this. Gonna do a little flip through. I want to put something in these things here, and I don't know exactly if maybe this. Oh, that would look pretty right in there. So what I'm gonna do in this video is that just move along and go along decorating this journal. It's not complete, but it almost is. And I wasn't sure whether or not to post it or videotape it as I was constructing it, because I really didn't know what I was doing. And I was trying to follow Donna and what she was doing, and I just didn't have the right size envelopes that she had. My envelopes weren't as pretty as hers. She had some beautiful vintage envelopes. Anyway, I used my own envelopes, which is okay. That's not bad. It's just a little bit different than what she constructed. So here's an envelope here with a pocket in the front. And here's another envelope, which I made the cover, the flip, first flip part, the top, and then also kept it open over here for a pocket as well. But I think this looks perfect like that with her head sticking out. Now, whether or not I should decorate this more, I think what I'm gonna do is just leave these as simple as possible and leave it to the recipient to decorate. And so I made this, so it goes like this, like that, and then like this. And I couldn't, I didn't like the white part in here. This is white. And what I did is I just went ahead and used the Distress Oxide and tea dye color and just tea dyed this. And then I kind of grunged up and shabbied up the edges of the envelope so that it kind of looks well, you know, shabby. And then it left me with a blank spot in the middle here. This was another envelope right here. And I love this look on the stamps. This is, I got a stamp collection. There was a stamp collector for an estate sale, and he had tons and tons of stamps, and was in a stamp club, and there were envelopes of different stamps that they collected or that they received. And so I loved the stamps, didn't like the subject matter that much. So what I did is I just covered it up so you can still see the stamp images vaguely, you know, the colors and everything. And I did that on tracing color. I copied digital, one of Heather's digital, onto tissue or onion skin paper, and then glued it on there. These are all digitals from Heather's kit, and I just kind of made scraps out of them. These are actually the scraps, and I kind of put a grommet and tied a bow on there, or tied. This is from a vintage scarf. So there's that. And then the other side of the envelope is a belly band, and then I made the envelope part of belly band as well. And I just loved this, the writing, and it's raised. It's like a imprinted embossed stamp that says Griffin on it. And I just kept it on there because I loved the blue and I loved the feel of it. And I made it into a kind of a pocket belly band. Look at this. Isn't that cute? She is adorable. Let's see, maybe I can just pin it to that. And put something inside it. Let's see. Look at this image. Isn't that beautiful? Aren't those ladies gorgeous? They look like they have had lots and lots of fun. So what I think I'm gonna do is put a document in here, an antique document. And put that through here, and that will be peeking through, and that will look really nice. I'll have to dig out one of my antique documents and do that, and then put something here like look at that. Isn't that pretty? Oh, I like that. Yeah, that's easy to close. So the one thing I love about this kit that she did these pictures on a background. So you didn't have to, it's not just white, plain white background. She did it on a decorative background. I want to put some lace right here. Let's see. Let's see what I've got with my scraps. So how's everyone doing? Thank you so much for joining me today. I tell you, it's been quite a week. My husband and I are planning to go on a camping trip. We are leaving tomorrow morning. We will be gone for several days, and that's kind of cute, right there, like that. What can I put on it? Should I put a pin? pin and a button. Oh, how about a what do you call those bulb pins? You put a bulb pin on there. Should I make a hole though for this? Maybe I should do a hole right there. Yeah, we're going on a camping trip, and it's gonna be about 3.5 hours away, I think, something like that. And it's gonna be a lot of fun. It's pretty remote, near the coast, and not sure if how the weather. Well, the weather's supposed to be like in the 60s, which to me is gonna be pretty cold at night. So, which is I lost my nail. Guys, yeah. So, excuse my nails and hands, by the way. But sometimes I don't have time to go get my nails done. And I don't have time to wait around for my nails to dry when I am doing them myself, when I'm painting. So, I use these wonderful things. Although, like you saw just here, they're great, and they're becoming more and more popular, simply because these days nobody has the time or the money. Look at that, that's cute, don't you think? Okay, so I'm gonna put that here. And then I want to put a document in here. I don't want to go take it out right now. That'll just take up too much time. And then what I did is I added a signature in one of the folds here. So I really shabbied up a lot of the papers and made it so there's some decorative pieces and also writing space. However, this is a little bit too white. Let me see. Here's some of Rachel's scraps that I scraps from a lot of these things in here, which they're just beautiful, beautiful stuff that she did. Beautiful work. Oh, I don't know what to do with that. But here, this is also in Rachel's kit, and I just, tore it and inked it up a little bit. Now, you can use whatever ink you want. I tend to use a lighter brown, which is the tea dye. A lot of people don't like it because they say it's a little orangey, but it doesn't look orangey to me. So, oh, that's cute. Yes, I'm gonna do that around the edges. I like to round the edges. It just makes it look a little bit more authentic, I guess. I don't know. Most vintage photos are square, but for some reason, the rounded edges look a lot better to me. Sorry, I'm just taking out. There's some blue border on this one. I don't want that. Let's see. I wonder if I should put something here. Well, I don't want to decorate it too much because I want to leave some decorating for whoever the recipient is. Okay, there's that. Maybe here is a little bit too white, too plain, but yeah, I might end up putting a little something on some of these white pages, just a little bit, because I do want to leave some writing space. This here, I thought would be good for a belly band. Do that here. Sorry, I'm quiet, just concentrating. I always have to concentrate when I'm gluing. Don't want to put glue all over the place. Okay, so that should be good. And I always have to wipe my hands from the glue, because I tell you why. It's not that I don't like gluey fingers. It's just that when I am re-gluing things down and pressing things down, my gluey fingers get onto the image, and it just messes it up. And so I try to clean my hands after I glue something, only because it makes a mess on those images. This would be kind of neat here, and make it a hidden pocket. Only problem is then it leaves this. But if I shabby it up and crinkle it, it won't matter. I think it'll look nice, I think. Okay, let's try it. Let me do it on this. I hope that you can see. Okay, just want to make sure I'm in frame, because sometimes that can be frustrating when you can't see what the person is doing. So I gotta say that I really admire Donna from Twisted Paper Studio. She is in a time in her life right now where things are going really well, and she's just doing so many cool things. I'm really excited for her. And she's so talented, and she's just so kind and friendly, that she totally deserves what's coming ahead for her. She's got a class in Texas that she will be a part of. I don't, not quite teaching it, but will be, doing some demonstrating, that looks good, don't you think? Oh, that looks beautiful. I just love shabby. I just love it. I love, love, love the shabby. But anyway, this I have seen envelope journals and tutorials before. I've been into junk journaling for the past, I want to say, couple years now. I am no expert by all means. I am still learning, still growing, still trying to, I make mistakes, and I don't do things the right way. But then again, they say in the junk journaling world, there is no wrong way. But I have to really commend the ladies that have been in it for quite a while. I think junk journaling actually is, although it's been like maybe, I want to say 5 years old, 5 to 7, maybe 7, 5 to 7 years old, it's still fairly new in comparison to other crafts like scrapbooking and, well, there's art journaling as well. Art journaling, that too is a little as different, and that's actually got me squirreled. I was looking at art journals and people who do art journaling and encaustic art, and then it just all of a sudden junk journaling just popped up in my feed, and it was like, wow, what is this? And it's was fascinating to me because I love old paper. I love vintage paper. I love vintage books. And what's the use of just keeping it and not utilizing it? And believe me, trying to break apart an old book that I've cherished, that was really hard. I think my first vintage book was a 1920 book, and it was the history of Oregon. And that's where I live currently. I live in Oregon, and that was really hard for me to break apart. But the pages were great for making, for collaging and making pages. I think that looks good. What do you guys think? I need to put something here. Ooh, that's pretty. Oh, but I don't. Something like that, a journal card. So what I have done, I have all these little. I made a master board, and I just did a. I just collaged a bunch of stuff onto this vintage fashion men's tailor book, and I cut them into like journaling size cards or tags, and just leave them. Look at that, that's pretty. Just leave them, and so that I can, as I make a journal, I can go to it and add things to it. Because what I found is when I started to complete the whole tag, I have a hard time fitting them into a journal. So this is a much, much better way for me to do this. I don't want to cover this though, I like that. I want to put some of Ruby and Pearl's digital on here, on so that it's kind of like this whole book can be Ruby and Pearl's sea stuff, seaside. What is it? Maybe Seaside Dreams and By the Sea kits. That way, it'll be a little bit more, it'll be matching a little more. Let me see. Maybe this can go into something else, but I think I will go ahead and glue this. And then tear it over here. There. I rarely ever measure. I just kind of, you know, fold and tear. Simply because I want to get this, you know, I want to be able to paste something down quickly. And not have to worry about measuring. And that's the beauty of junk journaling too, is that it doesn't have to be perfect. You don't have to measure everything. Okay. So there's that. Cover the glue, make sure it doesn't dry. And I gotta make sure this surface here is not sticky because it'll stick to my journal. I don't want to do that. I must confess, earlier I had to do this over. I was working on it and then I started gluing and then glue got stuck all over her face. And I tried to clean it, and the more I cleaned it, the worse it got, and ink and the printing, the ink kept coming off, so I had to pull it all apart and redo it. But she's fine now, thank goodness. I just love this, guys. I just love that. That is just so pretty. And I love how it goes right in here. I love that. And this is real pretty too. I might end up putting something right there. I don't know. I keep saying that I want to leave it for the recipient to decorate because, you know, that too is fun. That's a whole part of when you purchase something, you want to add some of your own ideas to the creation. Okay, here's some journaling space, and then I need to put something here, which let's see, I want to put something kind of blue and a little bit wide. This is pink and blue. That's kind of cute. And then I gotta put something on it that is like something like that. Oh my god, that is so cute. These images, this kit that Heather did, is, it's like, I think this is an older kit, it's not one of her newer kits, but I have so many of her things. I just love her stuff. And when I went through her shop and looked at all these other digitals that she had, it's like, oh my gosh, this is just the perfect thing. I don't think this is straight. I need to put something around there, though. I need something to break that up, like, maybe, like a packaging, brown packaging paper, or, brown packaging paper, maybe. Okay. Need elbow room. Okay. I don't want it too straight, but I don't want it too crooked either. Everybody has their own way of doing things, and I probably am not you know, there might be better ways to do what I am doing now. So please, if you can think of anything that I am, or if you see anything that I am not, that could be done a better way or a more efficient way, I guess is what I'm saying. Feel free to make a comment. That way I know that you guys are really paying attention to me. Oh my goodness, I think this keeps getting worse. And then, one more time, just right along here. So this camping place is called, it's in the coast, and it's pretty far away, and it's one of the, it is one of the forestries through the forestry department. And you go online and you can book a lot of cabins and lookout points and all through the forestry department. And and it's fairly inexpensive, and it's very, very remote, and a lot of forestry guys, you know, the forestry department, they, you know, they and their families or wherever. I mean, it's an unknown area. So, well, it's not widely known. I can't say it's not unknown. It's just not popular, and it's not populated. So you're out by the river, and not a lot of people, which is pretty cool. So I'm really looking forward to it. The downside is, now some people, well, this would be a turnoff for a lot of people, but my husband and I tend to like roughing it out in the wilderness. And so there is no running water and there's no electricity. So we're gonna rely on wood, gathering wood pieces, wood, whatever fallen wood is around the area. My husband talked to a ranger. We're going to stop by the ranger station too, and got to make sure too that there's no campfire restrictions, because, you know, it is that time of year. Here in Oregon, we're just notorious for forest fires, and just want to make sure that we've got everything all in line. Okay, so there's that. Grunged up, or not grunged up, but shabbied up. I feel like still there's something missing. What? Why? Why is it? Why is there something missing? Maybe a word? Yeah, I think maybe a word on there. Put it like that. Just so cute. She's adorable. I just love that little cutie. Yeah, a word going sideways, maybe. Or, let me see. Look at this one. Can you see her face? This is from Pam from the Paper Outpost. She's got great images too. She was one of the very first people that I followed when I first started. Something like that, huh? Something like that there. And then a word, maybe. I don't know. Like that, and a word. Okay, I think that's what I'm gonna do. Gonna put this on there. Whoops. It's already the cover was already off. Gosh, what a doofus. Okay, and then that there. And let's see if I can find a little word here. Let's go to good old Tim Holtz and find something. Let's find a single. Oh, timeless. Timeless. And let's kind of crunch that up a little bit. Just a little tiny, tiny bit. Not too much. And let's put some glue so that it stays stuck. And oh, just go like this. Timeless. It's a little too much glue. There. I think that'll be all right. It's okay for now. Things up. All right. It's really funny. I go through these phases where sometimes I don't want to ink, and other times I do. This, when I do this, it helps shabby up the paper, and then at the same time it also colors it. Okay. There. All right. Let's see what it looks like, what it will look like. Smash this down. Cute. All right. Okay, so far I've got the front here. I need to find something to go in here. This. Just kind of shabby it a little bit more. There we go. That looks better to me. And then this opens up, and I need something in here. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to just put a bunch of little Eferma bits in there. We got this. This is all little scrap scrap page. And I've got to find, oh yeah, I was gonna put a document in there. And then I have this here. I wonder if I should put something on that. Like, I don't know. Look at how cute. Oh my God, these darling little children are so cute. Something about little kids. They can either be really scary and creepy or really cute. Isn't that weird? Okay, all right, so we got that, and then we got this. And then we're gonna move on. This is a pocket. Pocket here. Uh-oh. Is it not? Aren't these ladies gorgeous? Okay. Pocket here. And then there's a short little pocket up here for something like this, maybe. No. Has to be smaller. Has to be shorter. Something like that. Right there. Okay, well, I'll think about it. Then there's a pocket here, and then this is journal pages, and then here is another scrap page, scrap paper page, and then here's another, it's a hidden pocket here. And then a pocket here. Okay. Well, we're almost done. So I think what I'll do is I'll end it here and then turn the camera on for the next time when I'm ready to go ahead and complete this. Thank you so much for being here and joining me today. I really appreciate it. If you can please, if this is your first time, please subscribe if you like the content. Subscribe, share, like, comment so that, I know that you are here with me. Thank you once again. Bye-bye.